Hello, we've got the barbecues fired up today because of the ever-increasing trend of people cooking outdoors. Last year, the UK was actually the largest market within Europe for outdoor cooking, with sales over £7 billion. So, on the board, we've got something a little bit different. Rather than your steaks and your burgers, we're going to look at some mini roasts, and we're going to talk about roasting on your barbecue. Here we've got three examples of a mini roast. We've got a little beef topside, we've got a lamb topside, and we've got a lamb thick flank. Now, all of these roasts are roughly around about 500 grams, and the design of these is actually to address the decline in the sales of large roasting joints. They're perfect for two people, and because of their short cooking time, they're actually suitable for a midweek cook as well. So, preparation on these, we're going to do something really simple. Just going to season them with some salt and pepper. When you've got good meat, don't need to do much. So, a little bit of sea salt all over. And if any goes onto the board, don't worry, because we're going to rub them around on the board and just press all that seasoning into it before we put them on the barbecue. Now, if you haven't thought about cooking roasts on your barbecue, it's really quite simple. We'll talk about it in a moment, but one of the main advantages of roasting on your barbecue is that actually you keep your meats extra juicy, because the barbecue sits outside, it's generally a little bit damper outside, and your barbecue draws in that dampness, which keeps your joints lovely and succulent. You can also achieve a beautiful result with these roasts just by cooking them in the oven. So over at the barbecue, we need to talk about how we roast as opposed to grill. On the barbecue, you've got two kinds of heat. You've got direct heat and indirect heat. Direct heat is where you have the heat directly underneath the cooking grate where you have your food. And in that kind of a setup, you do your burgers, sausages, kebabs, steaks, absolutely perfect. To roast on your barbecue, you need to move the heat to one side and create what's known as indirect heat. Always cooking with the lid on. If we look in the barbecue, you can see that I've got a bank of coals on the left-hand side, and I've got my roast sat away from the heat. And underneath there, I've got a few little drip trays just with some water in to help soak up the juices, but also to create extra moisture in the barbecue as well. So we've got our three little roasts here, and it's time to check that they're cooked. And the easiest way to do that is to use our digital probe. Tip of the probe into the deepest part of the meat, and then we're looking for a nice little 75 degrees for cooked. Again, tip of the probe into the deepest part, that's cooked. And again, the last little bit of lamb, 73, 76. These are all cooked, so we're gonna take these off the barbecue. So we'll put our beautiful little joints on the chopping board. Top side of beef, top side of lamb, and then the thick flank of lamb. There we go. Close that down. Okay, now it's the moment of truth. Slice into these little things, beautiful. So, starting with the thick flank of lamb. Nice and juicy, nice and succulent. You can see we've got beautiful cooked lamb, cooked all the way through on the barbecue. Nice and juicy, absolutely perfect. Second one, the little lamb topside. Look at this, absolutely stunning as well. And the fat's crisped up nicely. One of my little favorite parts of the lamb. And then the top side of beef. And then slice through that. Nice little bit of cooked top side of beef there. Absolutely stunning. So three little dishes, three little cuts of meat, mini roasts, that you could very, very happily put into your counter and add to your product range. Show your shoppers something a little bit different. And with the tips that we've covered off, hopefully they'll be able to go home and create these dishes themselves.